kena tak tebak. On this NEP Engineering Sample Art, they give NPSP. In this one is I call. This is a statement prepared by Jabatan Pemerintah. Presented by our legal advisor regarding this NEG, where they filed a suit of 243 million against MPSB. All the facts are here. Semua itu maklumat ada tertera dalam kenyataan rapat. And MPSB has lost its support against SPRM. This issue because of the involvement of one former leader who is still an active politician. Who is now presently still an active politician and hope that SPRM can investigate this matter seriously. And we are shocked at the amount that we are sued, 243 million. This one was definitely bankrupt. MPSB. We lost 230 million over the 6-7 year period from 2001 to 2007, 7 year period. MPSB telah kehilangan 230 juta di dalam tempoh 2000 hingga 2007, saya rasa. 2000 hingga 2007, MPSB telah kehilangan 230 juta. So, dia hampir bankrupt. Sebenarnya sudah bankrupt lah. Sudah bankrupt, tapi kita berjaya selamatkan ini 2008. Sekiranya kes ini jalan dan mereka menang, ini tak boleh hidup lagi lah. Pasti mati. Macam mana saya pandai atau mana-mana accountant pandai bayar 243 juta, kita kena tutup MPSB. Tolong bayangkan kalau tutup MPSB, apakah masa depan kerja-kerja, apakah masa depan warga MPSB. Warga Sarawak Pride. So, nasib baik kita menang. Dan saya difahamkan mereka tidak buat rayuan lagi lah. So, dia akan sudah lebih tempoh masa, dia akan sidang tentang tim. So, sudah lebih tempoh masa untuk kita menang kes ini. Tapi itulah cabaran dan itulah ancaman yang kita dapat kerana ada banyak kes-kes sama sedemikian yang kita belum tahu sama ada mereka akan faham sama di mahkamah. Dan yang menduga citakan ini melibatkan seorang bekas pemimpin yang sekarang masih menjadi ahli politik yang aktif, tentu dari parti pemakaman. Sekarang masih menjadi ahli politik yang aktif. When I say aktif, I say very aktif. Okay. Yang masih menjadi seorang ahli politik yang aktif, kita minta bahawa SPRM boleh buat siasatan penuh. So, when was the report from? Dan MPSB pun lapor kepada polis. Ini adalah seorang pemimpin pemakan yang masih aktif. Yang masih aktif. So, di sini kita tak tahu apa, ada apa-apa kes-kes lain di mana kita hadapi ancaman sedemikian. Bukan sahaja dekat MPSB, dahana kerajaan negeri juga mengenai kes-kes tanah. Ini bukan perkara kecil. Itu bila saya cakap bahawa kita hadapi ancaman pampasan ratusan juta, inilah salah satu kes ini. Bila kita hadapi ancaman berbayar pampasan dan ganti rugi ratusan juta ringgit, inilah contohnya. Dan itulah yang amat membimbangkan pihak kerajaan negeri kerana kita tak mahu baik MBBP maupun MPSB bankrupt. Kalau mereka ini berjaya, kita pasti bankrupt. Macam mana pandai saya? Orang cakap, oh, you bagus lah, boleh selamatkan MPSB daripada bankrupt 2008. Tapi kali ini, kalau kita bayar, macam mana pandai saya, saya pun angkat tangan. Betul-betul dengan baca Al-Fatihah. No, no way out. 243 million, no way out. Oh, really no way out. So itulah ancaman dan itulah keadaan bila sekarang kita masih hadapi salah laku yang dibuat oleh kerajaan lama. Ini 90s ni. 90s ni. Sampai 90-an mereka masih boleh hantui sama kita lagi. Dan itulah hantu-hantu yang kita terpaksa lawan. Yes, you want to ask me? Any questions on this? And we hope that SPRM, we can call the police lah. Kita buat laporan polis, the police rujuk kepada SPRM kan? So, kita harap SPRM boleh ambil tindakan yang serius tentang perkara ini. Pagi ini saya pun ada bangkitkan dengan Dato' Samaraju bila kita ada program dekat BDC tadi tentang itu ini itu penyu bisu lah, pemberi maklumat, hari pemberi maklumat. So, saya ada bangkitkan dengan Dato' Samaraju harap boleh disiasat kes ini. 243 million claim. Tuntutan 243 juta ringgit daripada MBSP. Tahun kes 97, akhirnya kita nasib baik kita menang. Dan sekarang masa rayuan sudah habis. So, harap selamatlah. Tapi saya tak tahu sama ada kes-kes lain tak. Jangan-jangan ada kes-kes lain, kita tak tahu. Itu selalu kita bimbang bila-bila masa akan faham satu kes lagi. Dihantui dengan hantu-hantu silam. Hantu-hantu masa silam. Okey, ada apa-apa soalan? Any questions? Yes.
I
want to
tell us who is the opposition for the
situation. Why don't you ask the I think it's not appropriate for me to say it now. But what I say, we hope that SPRM can investigate seriously.
When the report
what should we do? Kita buat laporan bila?
February.
February this year.
By our
Rosali. Bulan 2 tahun ni. February this year.
Ya,
dua-dua sekali. Tapi ini akan jadi case SPRM. Ini dibuat oleh MBSP ya. Okay. Any other questions? Yes.
The SPRM report following is on which issue? Also in this case.
The issue of the
SPRM, the
content of the SPRM.
Contents like I think that one is confidential. We let the SPRM investigate.
This one,
how did the matter arise? Yes, how did the matter arise? Because it involved an active politician. You are saying that why is there an element of conflict of interest? Why is there an element of conflict of interest that requires SPRM? Where is the cause of action? Where is the cause of action which requires SPRM to investigate? Because it involves an active position. A former leader who is still an active position. How did this matter arise? Because that person was involved.
How old is he?
I cannot ask a woman how old she is. So you cannot ask me how old that person is. Just then you'll know who that person is, isn't it? Okay? Any other questions except, don't ask me age, please. Any other questions except age?
So he's still holding any post in the NEG and
the I think that one I cannot reveal. Just say that I will ask SPRM to investigate to make sure SPRM can come up with a 3D outcome. You know, the recently the two Gelombang Power UMNO was charged for corruption, isn't it? Recently.
Yeah.
Rasuah pemimpin UMNO juga. At least you see there's some action here lah, before so they can investigate. But this one is Kedah punya case. So Kedah punya case, dia juga kebimbing UMNO duduk. Ini daripada Perumatan Pau lah. Perumatan Pau UMNO you, eh? UMNO you, sorry, aku dulu orang. Ya, ya, this one, saya nak mirip. Bahagian Perumatan Pau, dua seorang pemimpin. Naik Ketua Pemuda dan Pendahari UMNO Bahagian. So ini laporan nak menjadi. So this one was in Alostar. Ini Alostar tidak boleh. So I think this was done by SRM Kedah lah. So kita lihat SRM Kedah sekurang-kurangnya ada tindakan ke atas pemimpin UMNO Perumatan Pau. So kita harap bahawa itu SRM Pulau Pinang pun boleh ambil tindakan yang sama-sama serius. Rasuah pemimpin UMNO di Tunduk. Kadang-kadang kita pun simpati ini benci pihak kena besar lagi tak kena.
Is it related to
this? No. Because this one is in Kedah. There will be one in Penang. No, I just want to say that I know you are doing your job, I understand also. I know you are doing your job, thank you very much. I respect that, I respect you are doing your job. This one is in Kedah, this one in Penang, that one in Kedah. So it's different.
Does the white attach
this one? No, I just want to show that like in Kedah, the SPRM has taken action. And this one against UMNO Perumatan Pau. So this one we hope also they, in Penang, SPRM Penang, hope they can also take action lah. By the same time, I also simpati sikit lah. Kecil-kecil ni yang kena. Tapi yang besar-besar lagi, maha besar lagi, tak ada hal. Okay. Alright. Thank you. Anything else? 11th SPI.
Sorry. I think you ask, why did you ask the CM to reach? Who is that? You know,
okay.
No,
I didn't have to know the age, I understand. Yeah, but age we cannot say yourself. Because age will know them who really. Will they know who really?
Okay. Maybe I need to verify the tarikh kita pergi ke SPRM, sorry, it's not correct date. 18 December 2015, sorry. 18 December 2015, SPRM and Police Board.
Laporan dibuat pada bulan 12 tahun lepas. 18 Disember 2015. This is the. Okay, jump into surely better because you mentioned the process. Okay, so it's 18 December 2015. The report was filed 18 December 2015. Not February. Sorry. Please correct that. Please correct that. Sorry, the information delivered was wrong. 18 December 2015. Not February this year. Okay, so we go there. They will investigate. So it's quite some time really. More than 3 months. Okay, anything else?
So far, any updates from SBI?
What are you looking to plan? I think they are, of course, back and forth. They record statements, isn't it? I hope that we can get an early resolution. They recorded statements and all that.
So the
authorities,
they haven't charged the...
That's why I'm asking for speedy out. Yes, thank you.
You think the February 1 was the press conference at the NPSP?
Yes, I think your army said, yeah, you're right, I'm okay. That one was on the press conference. This one is on the report in December.